I told you that the president wanted to move the census so the White House could oversee it rather than the Commerce Department? And that was for power and control and money. And people said, oh, gee, what could he possibly do with the census, really? Here's what he could do with it. In fact, here's what he is doing with it now. He'll use the full power of the census to continue these big bloated government programs, not continue them, but expand them in perpetuity with one tweak of the system. You move it from the Commerce Department to the White House. Here is the latest from President Barack Obama. He is now proposing a new experimental scale to determine America's poverty level. Wow, I'm glad. He must never sleep thinking of these things. Right now, we base the poverty level on purchasing power. In other words, you're poor. How many potatoes can you buy? How much money do you need for a house and potatoes for your family? It's based on what you make and what you can buy. Obama's new scale would base poverty on what you can buy relative to what other people can buy. Excuse me? This is another way to redistribute the wealth. Your income can go from the current poverty level of $22,000, depending on family size, to $70,000 or $80,000 or more. And you'd still be considered poor. Because what do your neighbors have? Excuse me? Again? Excuse me? This new system will artificially increase the number of Americans considered poor. They need our help. They're poor. For instance, the number of Americans 65 and older considered poor will double. 9.7 now to 18.7 under the new measurement. Wow. How will that change the debate about Medicare, Medicaid, and health care? It will also likely send the number of people considered poor in the U.S. beyond the numbers of poor in impoverished nations like Bangladesh and Albania. Does anybody really believe that the United States has more poor people who are worse off than the people in Bangladesh? I don't think so. The Heritage Foundation looked at some government data. It shows the average, typical American poor person, according to the traditional pre-Obama poverty measure, as two color televisions, poor. They have a satellite or cable TV service. They have a VCR or DVD player. They have a stereo. This could be an old boxy 1990s, not a flat screen. I'm not sure. And I didn't mention about, you know, anything at all about broadband, you know, high-speed internet. How many people living in cardboard huts in southern Ethiopia can microwave a bowl of popcorn while watching HBO? Not too many, I'm guessing. Now, I want you to know, I'm not saying that being poor in America is sweet. It's not. It's never fun being poor. It's not opulent or overly ostentatious to be poor in America. But this isn't Zimbabwe.